tonight for this special event. And we welcome the Birmingham Southern Choir, directed by Dr. Lester Siegel. Birmingham Southern has a long tradition of excellence in music, especially choral music, and that's a reason why I and four other members of our family chose Birmingham Southern as our alma mater. And for all of us, the music experience and the total college experience at Birmingham Southern was transforming. And that's why we love Birmingham Southern College, and I am so delighted that they are here with us tonight. They're starting a trip. We're their first stop, and so we're in for a treat. Dr. Lester Siegel is a dear friend. We've been friends since he was in high school in Birmingham, and I was a little older than him, but he is also a graduate of Birmingham Southern College. He was also an organ major there. But he went on and did a doctorate in orchestral conducting at University of Colorado, Boulder, and then has gone back to Birmingham and had been there at Birmingham Southern for decades now. But this is his last semester. He's retiring, and so this is a kind of a farewell tour. But Lester's a dear friend, and so thank you, Lester, for doing it. And the kind of experience that I and my family members had in music, I'm sure that these students are also experiencing under Lester's guidance. So will you join me in welcoming the Birmingham Southern College Concert Choir, Dr. Lester Siegel.
Thank you. such a pleasure to return to Spring Hill Presbyterian. I've brought the choir here at least twice before in my 30 years, mostly because of the wonderful hospitality of Randy and Vera Lynn Sheets. And it's always a joy to come back, and by heavens, the room, what a great place to sing. What a beautiful acoustic environment it is. I know you benefit, those of you who are members of the church, from Randy and Vera Lynn's presence and the terrific musicianship that goes with them. And it's great to be here. We're thrilled. We're going to continue this tour program with the first two movements of William Byrd, Elizabethan, British composer of the 17th, well, Elizabethan era, of his Mass for Three Voices, and then continue with three songs ascribed to Mozart. They probably were not written by Mozart. They're a set of six nocturnes, and probably they were written by an acquaintance of Mozart who got help. That's the best theory I've heard. But we believe that Mozart probably did write the last of the songs that we're going to do. But the first two, we don't know. But they're charming. They're just light, airy pieces, probably best sung with music in one hand and a glass of wine in the other around the piano. But we're going to present those two.
Christ,
times for joining us. One is seated at the organ bench, my daughter-in-law, Jessie Ming. She is a mathematics teacher in Birmingham in Jefferson County system. Kelsey is assistant with special ed in the Mountain Brook school system in Birmingham. Kelsey Hutchins just graduated last year. And Daniel Siegel, who's married to Jesse, my son Daniel, they're all three graduates of Birmingham-Southern, and they graciously agreed to come and help swell our numbers just a little bit, and we're glad to have them. So in the way of something a little bit different, Daniel is going to offer one of the five mystical songs by Rafe Vaughan Williams. These are beautiful settings. You may be familiar with them, but they are from the religious-based poetry of George Herbert. And this one, "Love bade me welcome, yet my soul drew back, guilty of dust and sin," is a particularly poignant one, and it has a little moment for the choir also, which I just thought was just perfect. And so I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
The next two pieces are by a composer, contemporary composer, David Lang. He is the founder of the Bang on a Can Festival in New York City. Now, there's a lot of banging of cans in New York City, especially about 5 in the morning, but this is a little bit different. This is a new music initiative, and these two pieces really spoke to me, and the choir gradually began to respect the pieces, I think. Maybe they actually like it now. I don't know. It was a hard sell. I want to just take a moment and share the text of these two pieces. The first one is called Again After Ecclesiastes, and space did not permit me to put anything but the foreign language stuff in the program. But if you know your Ecclesiastes, you will pick up immediately on the theme of this text. People come and people go. The earth goes on and on. The sun rises, the sun sets, it rushes to where it rises again. The wind blows round, round and round. It stops. It blows again. All the rivers run to the sea, but the sea is never full. From where the rivers run, they run again. These things make me so tired. I can't speak. I can't see. I can't hear. What happened before will happen again. I forgot it all before. I will forget it all again. Cheerful little number. The second piece is, again, inspired actually from the Jewish liturgy. There is a prayer that is said at the end of every Jewish worship service, and most people of the Jewish faith associate this prayer with being in mourning or in remembrance for one who has passed. It's called Kaddish, which just simply means holy, holiness. But the prayer is a doxology. It never mentions death. It never addresses death in any way. It is one piece of big praise to God that's said at times when we remember those who have died. The last line of the Kaddish prayer says, "May the one who makes peace in the high heavens grant peace for us and for all the world, and let us say amen." Based on that, David Lang, I suspect in memory of his father, because that's the dedication, riffs on that text. If you can make peace in the heavens, in us, in all the world, make peace. concert choir repertoire. I think I sang that as an undergraduate, and I still love it to this day. We have one more piece. So we have one more piece in our program, and then we have our benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. Ludkin's piece. I think this has been done since the history of the concert choir began, way before me and even before Randy. But if you are an alum or even the spouse of an alum of this choir, we would be honored if you would come up and join and sing the Lord Bless You and Keep You with us. And then I want to ask you a question. We have a vocal jazz group that works out of this Hilltop Singers. It's about 8 of them. And they have a show. And I was wondering if you wouldn't mind if we just did a couple of encore numbers from them, just to let them sing a little bit. That's okay. So just be getting ready to come up. And I also got to mention the soloist tonight in Down in the River to Pray is Lindsay Jane Drummond. And I left somebody out. Layla Tajmir also has a solo that didn't make it into the program, but you'll hear it.
Sisters must go down, press go down, come on down.
to know how many people out there tonight are connected with Birmingham Southern College. If you're an alum or a parent of an alum, would you please stand for a minute? Because I suspect there are several of us. I know there are some of us out there.
Oh, you lucky people.
Thank you.
rain. You probably know this. So we got a couple of songs about the weather.